Alright, here we are for some more Kubera. I don't know how I feel today. We'll see how long this ends up being. I'm at least going to do two. We'll see if we do any more. See how I feel. Before we get into it, if you're new, consider hitting the sub button or maybe even the notification bell. If you really feel like staying up to date with everything I'm putting out, I will live 5 days a week. Kind of wild, I know. If you're not new, or even if you are new, like, comment, you know, usual YouTube stuff. We're very close to 400. Be really cool if we could hit it soon, and possibly even hit 500 before the end of the year. Kind of bussin'. Anyway, let's get into this, shall we? Sura Realm, year N1. Going back just a little bit, huh? Base of the Garuda Clan. I imagine. Oh god. Okay. Yeah. This is gonna be a rough one to say all of these names, isn't it? Welcome to Samfati. Akasha is waiting for you. Where's Maruna? He arrived first and is speaking with Akasha. All right. Okay. I'm not gonna comment just yet. I'm gonna say that for a little bit. Wow. I've never seen such a thing. Rakshasa above the Rakshasa. I would never have thought she was in this Tika if she hadn't said anything. Come on, let's see her. Let's actually get a good look at her. Come on. Part 2, Episode 103, Outsider 3. Your father is in a state of suspended animation, and your mother has been destroyed. This can't be easy for a mere third stage Rakshasa. I don't know whether you're mentally strong or just heartless. I was actually kind of expecting you to be crying. Why would you expect that? What happened to my mother is sad, but it's something that could happen anytime and anywhere in this world. I learned not to mourn things like that for very long. You're the one who taught me that, Akasha.
You may be arrogant, but you really do as you're told.
Akasha, Garuda Clan Nastika. With Garuda in the state of suspended animation and many of the strongest Nastika dead, she is the most powerful Nastika among the remaining Garuda. If Garuda dies in his comatose, Akasha will become the queen. This is who she was talking to, who Child Mary was talking to at the end of the last one. These basically effectively, standing head. What the fuck? Not the correct term for what I meant, but you know what I meant, probably. Someone will correct me on that, of that just brain dead statement. Good stuff.
Do all Gurudas get especially arrogant when they're in their third stage of growth? All of your older brothers were just as arrogant as you are when they were on their third stage too.
I don't want to hear about my brothers whom I have never met.
Maruna had a lot of older brothers, but they all died before Maruna was born.
How is the stay with the god Hava? Is it bearable?
From the way you're asking me if it's bearable, I take it that you know it isn't exactly a great place to stay.
It's just that I can't stand fishy smells either.
But they're birds. Surely they should really like fish. They're birds. Well, I mean, that's a joke. Not all birds eat fish. Very few, actually. Well, I don't know. I'm not a bird biologist, alright? Leave me alone. Shut up. Christ. What am I on about?
I don't mind, since I have gotten used to it after a while. The bigger issue is that God Hava throws me into a deadly situation as a way of making me grow.
That does tend to be the most common method, but you can always try it and go in another direction if it's not for you.
Maybe he just wanted the chance to beat me up, since I'm rather close to Shakuntala. She's the one who approached me first. Why is he taking his anger out on me? At least nowadays things aren't great for the God Hava, since their base got moved to the Sura Realm. The God Hava doesn't seem to have time to bother me. Is this amusing to you?
Things have just been so bad lately that I haven't had any time to laugh about. That I haven't had anything to laugh about. Now I'm laughing even at such a little thing. So, how did you evolve to third stage?
Interesting, so we're getting some of Maruna's background.
I heard rumors.
Why is the that got fucking... So it's just the positioning of him pausing before set. Okay.
The Kalavinka grew to third stage. I should have been happier to hear about my younger sister growing up. But I was upset. I'm her older brother. All I could think about was how embarrassing it would be if I met her again. It's right when I was upset after hearing about her that Godhava decided to toss me into a fiery pit like usual. I suddenly ended up growing like this, with sparks flying from my body.
I see. So the key to your growth to third stage was not wanting to lose to your sister. The growing to fourth stage may be surprisingly easy. There's a good chance we'll work with the standard techniques. Maruna, the reason I called you here is because you need to advance to fourth stage as quickly as possible.
I wonder, is it they're trying to make Maruna into a, you know, grow to Anastika? Can they grow to Anastika? I can't quite remember. I know that one of you will tell me in the comments, but if they can, I assume that that's the purpose of this, because, you know, he's directly related to Garuda. He'd be a good replacement as king. But interesting.
There's only around 4 years left, so you'd need to hurry.
4 years left? What will happen if I don't grow before then? Or maybe I'm just wrong.
If you don't, then all of your siblings will die. But it would be hard for you to grow all by yourself in 4 years. So I found someone to help you. Come on out, Samfadi.
The Rakshasa.
You probably haven't seen each other before. She's a publicly busy figure.
I need to sneeze, hold on. Very well. That was that. Samfadi, Garuda Clan, 5th stage Rakshasa. Oh wait, no, she is a Garuda. Yeah, I thought of something different. Ignore me. I got myself confused. Moving on. The first Rakshasa to have reached 5th stage in the shortest time. Only 5,000 years of the entire species. She appears to be psychologically lacking something, since revenge was her only motivation for growth. She sometimes behaves strangely.
I've heard about her. It must have been around 300 years ago that she reached 5th stage. Anyway, what was that you were saying before? All of my siblings will die if I don't grow in 4 years? Has something happened to Jatayu and Kalavinka?
Maruna, I suggest you don't mention that name in front of Samfadi. Jatayu, I mean. It was the name of Samfadi's sibling who passed away 300 years ago. The names of dead Rakshasa are sometimes given to newly born Rakshasa.
Wait. Something seems strange here. 300 years ago is when my brother escaped Taraka and joined the Garuda clan.
I've got hiccups, fuck.
If he was given that name at the time, does that mean he didn't have a name before then?
No, he did. He was just hiding it. Your brother hid his real name and joined the Garuda clan with a fake name, Jatayu.
Why? What reason could he have for needing to hide his name?
The power of a name, my good friend. Let's talk about this after you finish growing. Samfadi, take Maruna away.
Wait, can you at least explain what's what?
This is a very important secret. I can only tell my most trusted confidants. Maruna, if you can't grow within 4 years, you have no right to hear about this. If that happens, I'll send Samfadi instead of you.
Send her? Where?
To the human realm, most likely, I imagine, is what that's implying. And I take it that Samfadi might end up killing his siblings is why. He needs to grow in order to, you know, have them survive.
I need to rest. Sanfati, do whatever it takes to make him grow. Whether you need to beat him or torture him.
Wait, are you doing this because my father isn't here right now?
You can run away if you'd like, Marina. There's no reason for us to keep you here if you refuse to do the training. However, I hope you won't forget the lives of your siblings depend on you growing up. Right now, I'm giving you a chance to save them.
That is when things started getting so bad that I would actually miss the days that I would get beat up by Godhava.
It seems like things weren't exactly great for Bruna.
The conditions to get to the next stage vary for each Sura stuck at a certain stage. But most of the conditions involve fighting, rage, destructive instincts, will to dominate, showing off, possessiveness, jealousy, survival instinct, thirst for victory, appetite, revenge. And no matter what the conditions are, they all require experience, key. For instance, let's say there's a Sura whose condition for developing is survival instinct, the most common one. The Sura will not grow as soon as his life is threatened. Threats applied to inexperienced Sura are simply accumulated as experience.
They literally fucking level up. They outright actually just level up.
Once the accumulated experience reaches a certain point, they say the Sura with the strongest potential abilities require more experience. Any more experience would then be useless. At this stage, Sura requires an even more powerful experience than before in order to grow. And it's this moment of growth that we refer to as the key to growth. When I grew to third stage, apparently my aversion to losing to Galavinka was my key to growth. But the reason that was able to be a key for me was because of the experience I accumulated before then. I don't know why I'm yawning. It's not even early.
When are you gonna grow up, Marina? Am I gonna end up growing first again?
I wish I could smack her. I was relatively slow getting to third stage, but I wasn't in the worst situation. The worst situation is where your growth has stalled because your experience in the past has been so intense that you can't find an even stronger key to growth. Shes from the Kanara clan is the most famous example of this case. Since he's lived for so long, there's no reason for him to be lacking in experience. But because he's led such a dangerous life, he can't find a key to surpass his previous experiences, has been stuck at fourth stage for an astronomical period of time, and they say he'll never grow anymore at this point.
Why do I feel like that's going to end up being a story point? Now, given that they've brought that up specifically, I imagine that at some point, Shes, this motherfucker here, is going to evolve to fifth stage. Because something is going to happen. Something incredible is going to happen at some point during the story that is going to trigger his growth.
Conversely, Sanfati, who reached fifth stage in the shortest period of time in the history of the entire species, is a Rakshasa who has lived for far more peacefully than Shes. Born as a fairly average girl to a high Ragnostika parents, she spent a relatively quiet growth period for Asura and reached fourth stage after 700 years, which is slightly lower than average. Her growth to fifth stage was different. Like most Asura, she had basically given up on growing to fifth stage, but something happened that caused her to grow to fifth stage in an unexpectedly short period of time. In spite of fifth stage requiring a lot of experience, her growth was almost bizarrely sudden and is known for being very unusual.
Part 2-104, Outsider 4.
Well, simply fighting really be enough? It's not like I can beat you anyway. If I'm supposed to just stand here and get beaten up, I've already gotten enough of that from Godhava. If my growth requirement for 4th stage is survival instinct, I may never end up growing just like Shus. It wouldn't be easy fighting a more dangerous situation than letting Godhava kick me around.
You can't obtain experience or your key while in Sura form. You can only train for growth while in human form. You're allowed to take out your wings, though.
She just completely ignores me, saying whatever she wants to say. Well, I know that much. Godhava was already beating me up under the pretext of trying to make me grow. And he's always said I had to be in human form.
Esto Maruna's voice makes me yawn. Interesting, to say the least.
Since you've already taken a lot of damage from Godhava, most experience probably won't be enough for you. And judging by how long it took for you to reach the last growth stage, you require a lot of experience. But you only have a short period of time. So I'm going to really go hard on you right from the start. You won't have a chance to rest.
What? How can I not even rest during training? Don't I need rest to recover?
It looks like Godhava didn't feel like using his transcendental recovery skill on you. From now on, you'll only be able to rest when I run out of vigor and can't restore your health.
What? Rakshasa 5th stage is better than previous stages in almost every aspect. But the greatest difference of all is vigor. Not only does she have a higher vigor capacity, but she even possesses the Nastika feature where she recovers vigor without eating. When I first started training, all I could do was get beaten up for over a month until some fadi ran out of vigor. I never thought I would actually miss the days when I was getting beaten up by Godhava. I also realized that Godhava actually went easy on me. But I really realized that there was a bigger difference in displeasure. Between getting beaten up by a Nastika, who's superior to me, and a king at that, getting beaten up by a Rakshasa, who's really in the same class as me, regardless of her stage. I'm seriously wondering whether sticking flowers in her hair like that is a way of saying I'm nuts. When you think about it, shouldn't beating someone up like this drive her as crazy as the one being beaten up? I really don't have a choice, but what about her? Is she sick of this? Plus, she hasn't said a word since we started training. That's it. At this rate, I'll end up collapsing from boredom. I should try saying something to her. Hey. What color are your wings? I haven't seen them before. Are they black, like the feathers in your hair?
These are feathers from my dead sister.
I see. That's not really your fault, Maruna. That...
Damn it. I should have kept my mouth shut.
She was beautiful when she smiled, but I can't remember her very well. It's only been 300 years and yet my memories are already getting blurry. I can't possibly forget her this quickly.
Do you know who did it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah? Then you must have avenged her. At your level, you probably could beat most, Sarah. Was the guy stronger than you? A Rakshasa in 5th stage from another clan? Or a Nastika?
Get up. You've been resting for too long.
Are you nuts? It hasn't even been 5 minutes! I've hardly even rested! Just you wait. As soon as I grow...
Hurry up and grow then.
Why is only one of her feet, like, transformed? And why is she wearing, like, a shoe? Well, a heel on the other one. Like, why? I have questions.
At the time, some thought it was the most revolting, loathsome girl in the world to me. I had no other choice. Because I had no idea who her enemy was. I could not even begin to guess how she would have felt it was training me. Oh. Oh. Oh.
I have some ideas, but we'll leave them for now.
I had no idea you had such a hard time growing.
That's not the important thing here. You hid your real name and joined the Garuda under the fake name of Jitayu. And you and Kalavinka will die if I don't grow. From your perspective, why did I read that as respective? Don't you think these are bigger problems? Why haven't you asked or denied anything the entire time while I was talking? Should I take this to mean that you acknowledge everything I said is true?
Brother?
Jitayu, this time right now is even harder for me than when I was getting beaten up. I came all this way because I wanted to save you and Kalavinka. And now I'm not even sure I'm going in the right direction. Seeing you all grown up makes me wonder that even more. Is it really true that you do not know anything? Are you really just a Rakshasa who's barely 500 years old? Are you really my brother?
Damn. Fuck. Right. I'm gonna leave that there. That seems like a really nice point to wrap it up at to continue on next time. Well, I hope you all enjoyed. I've been Animosity, you've been you, and I hope to catch you all next time for another video. Ta-ta. For now.